Hi and welcome or welcome back to BookTube with Amy. This is going to be my first wrap up of 2022. So the first book that I read in 2022 in January was Dead Until Dark by Charlene Harris. It'll shock nobody who's a regular subscriber to the channel that this is one of the first books I had picked up. Me and Ange from Angie's Book Chatter are hosting the Out of the Coffin read-along this year, which is where we read one of the Sookie Stackhouse novels every single month of the year, except in June, where we get an extra. So I've been so looking forward to getting round to this. It is a surprise that I didn't just read it before the read-along started, but I managed to hold off. I had some self-control. I'm not going to talk too much about it just now, because me and Angel do a video at the end of the month where we discuss our thoughts and we have some discussion points. So if you're one of the people who are doing the read-along with us, look out for the date of that video going up. Come and join us in the comments to have a chat about it, and we can discuss the book, how we enjoyed it, and then just some social commentary around the world that Charlene Harris has created. This was a 5-star read for me. It was brilliant. I loved it just as much on a reread as I did when I initially read it. I think I could reread this a million times in my life and it will always be a 5-star. So I thoroughly enjoyed it. If you are interested in joining the read along, you have the rest of January to read this book. So come join us. I will link the Discord and everything down below in the description box. Come and hang out with us, chat about some vampire books. It's going to be a great time. And then I read Dear Laura by Gemma Amor. This is a short horror story about a girl whose friend goes missing and she starts receiving letters on her birthday asking her to comply with instructions in order to get information on her missing friend. And she sometimes complies, sometimes ignores them. And it's just about her growing up with this constant torment of it all. And I wasn't a huge fan of this book, although the premise sounds amazing. There was only one point in the book where I was genuinely scared and I didn't connect to our main character at all, which is disappointing. I know it's a short novel, however I have read short stories where I have connected to characters far more than I connected to our main character in this. So I was lacking that connection, so then I didn't really care about anything that was going on. And there was just some unnecessary stuff in this book, I felt. I feel like if we focused far less on the fact that the guy who was doing it is a pedo, and we focused less on his creepy, pervy requests, we focused more on character development, I think it would have been a much better book, in my opinion. It was just very forgettable. I think that when it comes to the end of the year, I will have completely forgot that I read this. And like I say, there was only one scene in it where I actually felt a wee bit freaked out, or I felt anything really. Other than that, it was just a quick wee forgettable read. So this is a 1-star for me. I wouldn't recommend it. It just wasn't my cup of tea. It wasn't up my street. I then did another buddy read, and I buddy read The Rabbits by Terry Miles with Scott from Gunpowder Fiction and Plot. So this book is about some sort of real world sci-fi-esque game that is happening, and we have our main protagonist Kay. They are obsessed with rabbits, have been their entire life, and they are approached by an elusive millionaire who is saying, listen, there's something wrong with the game and we need your help to fix it. We then follow Kay through the entire book about them trying to find out more about the game, about them getting close to other people who have played the game, and people are going missing, people are dropping like flies. So it's all about them just trying to figure out what is actually going on and getting to the bottom of rabbits. So I had been really excited for this one. So we had suggested that we were going to do a buddy read together, and to be honest with you, I enjoyed me and Scott's commentary far more than I actually enjoyed the book. Firstly, I didn't connect to a single character in here. Really, there was one sort of obscure side character that I found to be a bit interesting that our main characters in this I just did not get on board with at all. There was no character development for me across the space of the entire book, which we know is something that I really look for as a reader, so that let it down. I also think in terms of plot, it was a bit predictable, personally. You might read it and you might not see twists and turns or plot points coming, but for me, it was quite predictable and nothing was a surprise. Something would happen in this book and I was just like, of course it would. Like, of course it's going to. So that was a wee bit disappointing as a reader to feel like I knew everything that was going to happen. However, there were a couple of points in this book that were really interesting. So I'm not going to spoil any of the plot points. It's going to be spoiler free. What I will say though is the references in this book are really heavily woven into the world. In the beginning, there's really heavy references to old school gaming and old school games. And then as the tone of the book shifts and the themes of the story change and it's getting a wee bit more serious, whatever Terry Miles is choosing to reference shifts, and so we start referencing deeper, darker things, which I find really interesting, and I got majority of the references that are in this book. But I think that if you are not a big game fan and you're not a humongous horror fan, then you might miss out on a lot of the references that are being made, which would be disappointing, because for me it was one of the most interesting things of the book. It was what really helped me build a sense of who these characters were in my mind, because like I say, there's not a lot of character development, and it really created this sense of building dread, almost like, well, what are we going to reference next? And I really enjoyed that aspect of it, but I think that that is the only bit of the book that I really enjoyed. But I rated it a 2 stars overall. That was its one redeeming quality. It was something that kept me going through the read. I says this to Scott, but I think that if this wasn't a buddy read, I would have probably DNF'd the book about the halfway mark. It was just really disappointing the way that we were getting information, and it's set up to be a mystery. Obviously, we are with Kay and we're on their journey to trying to figure out what is happening, but we weren't really right there with them. They were doing it themselves and we were just observing. Whereas I would have far more appreciated if maybe Terry Miles used some different types of mediums, whether it was pictures in the book, whether it was, you know, QR codes in it that we could have scanned and watched videos on our phone or something like that. You know, Spotify playlists we could have linked in, and it could have linked to like a specific bit of the podcast, because Terry Miles also runs a podcast around rabbits as well. That could have been far more interesting, and it could have made us feel like we were along on the journey and that we were trying to find out clues and solve riddles for ourselves, as opposed to us just watching while Kay did it. So that was another big miss for me. I thought it was going to be a lot more interactive, and you know, there's other authors out there who have done fantastic jobs of that. Mark Z. Danielewski, in terms of House of Leaves, uses loads of different ways to convey what is happening in the story and, you know, convey different stories at the same time and have them all be just as intriguing and just as interesting. J.J. Abrams wrote S and managed to convey things again in different formats in the book to have it more an interactive experience. So there's other authors out there who have done it better, and I appreciate that this is a debut novel for Terry Miles. I just think there could have been more thought and effort put into it, especially considering I personally feel like the target audience are people who are into, you know, conspiracy theories and let games take over their life. Like, that's me. Hello, I'm Amy. Nice to meet you. So a book that was a wee bit more interactive, I think, would have been more engaging, particularly with that audience as well. So it was a 2-star for me. So that is everything that I have been reading this week. If you've read any of these books, comment down below. We can have a chat about them. Hopefully you are enjoying everything that you're reading at the moment, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!